Brett D'Oliveira made family history for Worcestershire with a fine century against Essex on day three. Worcestershire made somewhat of a fight back on day three against Essex, with Joe Leach at the centre of it, bowling Ravi Bopara for 48. Leach struck again to remove Dan Lawrence for a duck, Tom Kola-Cadmore with the catch. Not done there, Leach then trapped Jesse Ryder leg before, another Essex batsman going for zero. Leach took his fourth wicket of the innings, removing star Essex batsman Alistair Cook with an excellent catch of his own bowling. The England captain dismissed for an excellent 142. James Foster entered the fray and wasted little time picking up where Cook left off, reeling off a couple of sixes in a quick-fire innings of 51. He lost his partner Graham Napier, Matt Henry taking the catch off a teasing Jack Chantrey delivery. Essex declared on 451 for 9 shortly after. Darryl Mitchell and Brett D'Oliveira, who had a day to remember, opened at the crease for Worcestershire, forging a solid partnership. It didn't take either man long to reach their own half-centuries, but it would be D'Oliveira who would push on, making history by becoming the third generation of his family to score a championship century for Worcestershire. Mitchell fell early in the evening, Napier claiming him for a respectable 66. Moeen Ali hit 2 fours of his own at the crease, but Napier would strike again to remove the England man for 8. The day belonged to D'Oliveira, who continued to find the boundary until the end of his innings, finally caught by Ryder off Jamie Porter for 128. Despite D'Oliveira's heroics, Essex remained in the driving seat as Worcestershire trailed them by 225 runs with 5 wickets remaining.